Hello, everyone. My name is Marcel Scherello, and I'm here to tell the story of the audio player. I started around 1 year ago when I was searching for a streaming solution for my kids to have them playing the music files from a shared library on the tablets. And after searching a lot, I started with a fork of an old app called MP3 Player, which was pretty abandoned and not really operating back then. After getting it up and running and fixing the most basic issues, I decided to put it up to the App Store to make it usable for other users. Yeah, and then the story started. 1 year later, we had quite a lot of feature releases, being at version 2 already, and with the current version, over 19,000 downloads, made us pretty happy, and was a little bit more success, and then also corresponding work than we had expected at the beginning. The audio player itself, all the features you would expect from an audio player, all the major MIME types, MP3, FLAC, whatever you need. Standard features like ID3 tagging, media folders, a lot of core Nextcloud integration, like integrating into the share dialogues. We have the share player. It's integrated into the files app that you can play the audio files directly with a one click. From the files, search integration, favorite integration, smart playlists, everything you would expect here. And we even managed to get it maintained in 7 languages, and we put up quite some documentation in the wiki also. To get there was quite some challenge because we are only like a two-man team. It's myself doing all the development, and then Thomas Marx, who is the specialist for everything that comes to languages, grammar, grammatics, and especially the testing. We are really non-professional developers. We're only doing this as a hobby. So we really had to fight to get the app that far. Some of the main issues were, for example, the documentation. If you look at the API documentation, as far as I know, the Nextcloud still doesn't have one. I'm still still using the own cloud one. The documentation or the community developer support was sometimes a little bit could have been better if you're a beginner. The documentation, like the demo apps, are there, but it's hard to get up and started if you're really non-professional developers. And then also, if you have to deliver app to several releases of own cloud, next cloud, different versions, and then all these depreciations which come from year to year, made us quite some headache. It gave us a lot of try and error, a lot of patience in the IRC, Nextcloud Dev Channel, or in the forum. In this context, some special thanks to Bernhard from the news app. He had some very patient support for a lot of, let's say, beginner questions, and he helped us a lot. And the third source to get everything running is our other GitHub apps to serve there and search how they did it. So over the year, we ended up with around 1,000 commits, only mostly by two of us, to get the app up and running. The only chance to deliver the app in the scale was to focus then on a very detailed testing strategy. We have currently 2 pies and 1 web hosting packages to operate for ourselves different instances from Nextcloud, OwnCloud, current version, previous version, plus some betas, and then all the database combinations. So currently, whatever we fix, whatever release in a new version, we test it across 6 test instances to have all the possibilities covered as good as possible for the user. We document the test cases, which we manage via the GitHub project, which is very helpful here. And with this precision, we managed to keep the ticket count to around 10 for a new feature release, which saved us a lot of work afterwards. where do we want to go? One of the main features that we are currently working on is the integration of streams also, that we can include web streams like web radios also in the audio player. Perhaps even then including playlist files like these M3Us files, code cleanup, a better handling of huge libraries. This is always a task with users of 20,000 and more audio files. We did quite some improvements there for the performance, backend and Java frontend. We still want to tweak a little bit more. And then perhaps some more integration into other apps like the notifications or perhaps a player integration into the dashboard app. We have to see what we can find out here. And to close this, a little request for support. We have two issues where we are really fighting for a long time, and perhaps someone here in the audience could contact us later for some support here. We still did not manage to connect Transifex to our repo. Somehow we were not possible. Yeah, still. I'd like to get some support here, and we still searching for a CSS guru. We have one ticket still open for almost half a year already, where I can't figure out how to solve some certain position tagging CSS issue. If someone could volunteer here to support on these two things, he would be very happy. Thank you, Andres.